Hey dear learners, welcome back to e-learning platform of GS College of Commerce, Vardha. I'm Assistant Professor Rajeshwari Sharma and this lecture is for the BCom 6th semester for subject Advanced Statistics. Here, in this subject, we are dealing with the correlation analysis. Till now, we have seen the simple problems in correlation analysis. Today, we are going to move towards the next step, that is the calculation of probable error. Because when you are asked a question for the 16 marks in the examination, you are being asked to calculate the coefficient of correlation and the probable error from the given data. So for this, we need to understand the concept in the calculation of probable error as well. Okay, so we can directly calculate the probable error by applying the formula that I can give you. By putting the values in the formula, but I feel that theory of any concept is very important to be learned for understanding that concept in detail and for making the application of that concept. That is why here we are going to deal with the concept of probable error in detail. We will see the meaning of the probable error, we will see why it is calculated, and we will see how it is applied, how it is being used, okay? In actual situations. Okay, so let's begin with the meaning of probable error. So first of all, let me tell you that this probable error is represented by PE, that you can see here I have written on the board. Then let's see what has been given in the meaning. So here in meaning, it is being given that the probable error of correlation coefficient helps in determining the accuracy and reliability of value of R. So, in this meaning, some words are most important. So, I have underlined it here, like determining the accuracy and reliability of the value of R. Okay, so from this, we basically understand that probable error is a tool which helps us to check the accuracy of the value of coefficient of correlation. Like we in problem, we have seen that we have been given the value of the different items, number the series X and the series Y, and the series X and the series Y represents the different variables. Okay, and with the help of that given data, what we do, we find the coefficient of correlation, which helps us to interpret the relationship between the two variables. Like it helps us to understand what kind of relationship is there, either it's negative relationship or it's a positive relationship. If there is a relationship, so whether it's a strong, whether it's a moderate or a slow. So this R helps us to find out all these things. But when we talk about the accuracy of the value of R, so how do we get to know whether the value of R that we have calculated is accurate or not? So of course, this probable error gives us the tool. This probable error is basically a tool which helps us to determine the accuracy and the reliability of value of R. Okay. So, I just hope that you're clear with the concept of probable error over here. Now, we will see how it's calculated. So, for calculating the probable error, we have a formula. Let's see what's the formula. Here, you can see PE is equals to 0.6745 into 1 minus R square upon under root N. So, here, this 0.6745 and 1 remains constant in the formula. Then this R square, R whole square here, R refers to the value of coefficient of correlation that we are going to calculate with the help of given data, and N refers to the number of items that has been given in the different series, okay, which has been given for the calculation of coefficient of correlation. So this formula can be applied for calculating the value of probable error. Now, in the meaning, while discussing the meaning, I have told you that this value of R is helped to determine the significance of the value of R, or is this probable error helps to check the accuracy or the reliability of the value of R. So, the question that arises to our mind is how the value of this probable error helps us to check the accuracy of R. So here we will see the different things which will help us to determine that how this probable error helps us to check the accuracy of R. Okay, so first thing is given. Let's see what is given. If value of R is less than probable error, it shows that there is no correlation between the variables. So R is not at all significant. Okay, so what is given here? Here it's given if R is less than PE, means this is R, if it's less than PE, so it shows that there is no relationship between the given variables. Let's say we have been given two variables, X and Y, okay, and we have calculated the R with this variable, okay, R, value of R with this variable, and the value of R has come to 0.90, okay. Now, we will calculate the probable error, okay. How do we calculate the probable error? By applying this formula. Let's see, 0.6745 into 1 minus R square, means 0.90 square under root N. Means, let's say this value, items given under X and Y was 10, okay. So we will say under root 10, okay. So this way we have put the values in formula, okay. So now we will calculate 0.6745 into 1 minus 0.90 ka square, we will calculate it 0.81, okay. 0.81, then under root 10, so under root 10, 10 under root, it comes to 3.16, okay. 3.16, then 0.6745 into 1 minus 0.19 upon 3.16, then 0.6745 into 0.19 divided by 3.16 is equals to 0.06. okay, so 0.6745 into 0.06, so here we will get 0.04, okay, 0.04. So this way we have got the value of PE as 0.04 in case if the value of R is 0.90, okay. So here you can see that the value of R is 0.90 and the value of PE is 0.04. So here what you can see, the value of R is greater than the value of PE. Therefore, here we will say that the coefficient of correlation is significant. But just assume, instead of the 0.04, if we would have got some value whereby the R would have been less than this probable error, so here we would have concluded that there is no relationship between the two variables X and Y, and the coefficient of correlation, that is the value of R that we have got, is completely insignificant. Okay, that would be our conclusion. So I have told you with the help of example that how the probable error is calculated over here. Okay, then the second thing to determine the accuracy level is that if value of R is 6 times more than probable error, so correlation is said to be certain. It shows that value of R is significant. Okay, so what is being said in the second statement? If the value of R is more than 6 times of probable error, so it is said that there is significant coefficient of correlation is significant. Okay, means it shows that there is certain or the strong relationship between the given variables. So here basically what we can say, if the value of R is greater than the 6 time of the value of probable error, so we can say that the, between the given variables, that is X and Y, there is a strong correlation, there is certainly correlation, and whatever the value of R we have got is significant. Okay, so this is the second interpretation of the probable error. This is the second way to see whether the value of R is significant or not with the help of probable error. Then another thing is, by adding and subtracting the value of probable error from the value of R, we get upper and lower limit within which the coefficient of correlation is expected to lie. So what is the another thing, for what purpose this value of probable error is used? If we add or subtract the value of the probable error in the value of R, so we get the upper and lower limits within which the coefficient of correlation is expected to lie. So this value of probable error is also used to calculate the upper and lower limit, okay, along with the coefficient of correlation. This value of probable error is used to calculate the upper and lower limit within which the coefficient of correlation is expected to lie. So this way, this value of probable error, this tool of probable error, helps us to check the accuracy of the value of R. Okay, so here we are done with the concept of probable error. From the next lecture, we will see the calculation of probable error in this given problems as well. So till then, just keep watching the YouTube lectures. In case you are going to have any doubt, so you can contact me. Okay, you can WhatsApp me. You would be given the problems in your YouTube link, and at the same time, I would be giving you the PDF of problems in your Google Classroom as well. So guys, keep watching the lectures. Stay hungry for the knowledge. Thank you so much.